So since these hives were installed, we haven't done much besides giving them room. We had frames of honey from last year that we put in the fridge to just keep it good. This time we put on an extra box, put two or three frames of honey in each one of these in the top box, and we're gonna see how well they've eaten it all up or if they've done anything more with it. Just making sure there's no queen on this. So last time, these were all full of honey when we put them in here. There's no honey on them anymore. There's a few pollen stores.
Why did we put the honey in?
To give them a, help them get started on building comb and give them a little head start on being a new hive.
So instead of giving them sugar water, we gave them
brood.
Combs of honey.
Queen cup.
Oh look, a little queen cup.
Two queen cups. One on bottom, one on top. There's brood.
Queen cups on the bottom.
There's
and the
eggs
top.
Too.
Do you remember what the significance is of the queen cup being in either position?
I know there is a difference, but I don't remember how big of a difference it is.
We're going to have to go look that up because I don't remember either.
It was brewed on this frame though, which is...
Can you tell if the queen cups have anything in them?
No, they do not.
They're empty?
Yes, they are.
They seem fairly gentle right now. Are they putting brood in the second box?
There's brood on this one as well. It's not huge, but there is brood.
Is it babies or can you
see
eggs?
I see larvae, big and small. I see bees right before they're going to get capped. See pretty much all stages. Still no queen, so I probably will not be in this top box.
Now initially when we put these in full of honey and we did a check a week later, we discovered that my thought was that we should put the frames separated, so several inches between them, so they wouldn't build on them, they would just eat the honey, and we could come back and either move the frames or collect the frames. Well, that was a bad idea because they ended up building some burr comb, or cross comb, not burr comb, cross comb between the frames. So even though putting the honey in, I think, was a fine idea because it was a natural food source, doing it in a way that violated the bee space was not a good idea. Any beetles?
Two, three.
Three beetles?
Four.
So right now we're in the bottom box of hive number five, just checking to see what type of work they've done in that lower box.
Doesn't look like much.
So on the very outside frame, this is one with a black foundation.
Nothing.
No building of comb at all. Yeah, turn that around.
This side of the comb was directly next to the original frames, so they did build on that a bit.
You don't see the queen on there, do you?
No. There's also no brood on it, so I don't think she would be on this one.
So now we're getting into the original five frames that came with the nuke. Lots of bees.
Solid brood.
Lots of brood. Well, that smoke's coming in heavy right now.
Yeah, we put it on the other side. There's the queen.
You see the queen?
Mm-hmm. Top left.
Oh, yeah. There she is. She's pretty.
She's not running away either.
She's not camera shy. Okay, so now that you've seen the queen, you've seen brood,
I'm
eggs.
I'm gonna go ahead and close it up, but
yeah, there's no point.
She has all her legs, her wings aren't damaged, so I don't think, unless she's just getting old, I don't think those queen cups have significant value.
Well, like we did on the other hive, I think we may be just as well to let them requeen if they want.
We could even pull that frame out and put it in a new nuke hive, maybe.
Oh, the one with the queen cups?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess we could, but there's not enough, really, I don't think. There's not enough in this hive to warrant splitting it, I don't think. So the plan for this hive, our hive number five, is that we're just going to add the additional frames to that top box and close it up. That queen and the colony appear to be doing pretty well. Okay, moving on to hive number four. And we're naming these by the positions 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. This is hive four. Did not get an extra box. We didn't have enough honey frames. So we're just going to check to see how this one's doing. Initially, this one, when we put the nukes in, I think, didn't we experience that this one seemed a little weaker?
I think so. I think this was the one that didn't need to be put in a box right away.
That's probably true. Lots of bees spilled out on that one. I'm gonna make sure we didn't lose the queen. Just lots of workers now angry at us because we rolled them right off the edge.
There are a lot of bees in this hive.
Yes. Way to shake them up. Overall, I mean, they sound a little angry, they're buzzing around, but they're not attacking me and my camera like normally they are, so I'm actually pretty pleased that they seem somewhat gentle.
No comb. No queen. There's so many bees, but I don't understand why they're not building comb.
Well, maybe they have enough. There's lots of pollen in their little legs. I'm sure somebody with more experience would be able to say that the posture of those bees...
Hey, this is not an original frame and it does have brood.
They've built enough comb to start laying brood in that extra frame, so that's good. You got brood in that one?
Yeah. Not seen a lot of food stores though. So far. More brood.
You see eggs?
Yeah. I think these are guys that kind of need fed. Because they have brood, but they don't have food.
Okay. So we'll bring another box and put on top of that one and put some syrup in there. Is that as far as you're going on this one?
Yeah. Because I know there's brood, I know the queen is laying, and I haven't seen any queen cups, so I know there's a queen. There's actually a lot more bees in this one than I thought there would be.
Now on hives 1, 2, and 3 have the smaller holes for the entrance reducers. So
whoa,
we'll just
look at that.
Pulling that out. Oh, that's pretty cool.
For all the pollen. You can see how much pollen they actually bring in.
Yeah, we're gonna put that on the bigger opening so they have a little more space. It's plenty warm.
They're all still trying to go in the small one. How yellow that is from pollen.
There's a lot of pollen going through there. Just adding regular wood chips. I think it's just pine bedding.
No chemicals.
No chemicals. Just plain raw pine bedding. So hive number 3. This is one that only got 2 honey frames on the top. Yes, and while we're out here, next time we need to bring the loppers so we can cut some of this tree back. It's a little annoying. Especially when this tree has these long thorns on it, so it ends up sticking you.
There's no honey, there's no nothing on this.
Yeah, and again, it was my idea to put the top cover on first, so that top box would truly be just a food store. Not sure if that was the best idea, but seems like it worked out okay. You can see that there is a little bit of comb in here.
This also only had 9 frames.
We didn't bring any deep frames back, did we?
Nope.
Okay, we'll have to remember next time to bring a deep frame for that. So they are building some comb on the top.
I know that
inside
this
of
one
the
has a neon.
Doesn't look like they're building a whole lot. You can put that over on the other side. A lot of activity. Seems like a healthy hive.
Oh, the queen top. Brood. lot of pollen, some brood. Nothing.
No brood?
Just a little bit in the middle. Oh yeah, there is a little bit in the middle with the eggs.
Let me see if we can see eggs.
I think your fuzzy thing is gonna catch it before. Hey, there's honey.
So they're storing food, pollen, and honey.
On this frame. Sweat dripping down the nose.
So we have seen eggs and brood and honey.
Plenty of brood.
So yeah,
queen cups.
Nice pattern.
Two.
Is that the queen right there? I think that's her.
That's a drone.
Are you sure?
That's a drone.
Oh.
Might be an egg in that queen cup. There might be an egg in that queen cup to the right.
In both of them or just the one?
I can't see in this. Oh, there's the queen.
Where?
Left.
Oh yeah, there she is.
I don't know why there would
be. Be careful with her when you put her back.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we've seen eggs. We've seen...
Oh, fine, brood on this side.
Brood, we've seen the queen.
They might need food as well though.
Okay.
Where is she?
Gentle. These bees seem a little bigger, don't they?
They do. They're not small.
You need to push those all together for the empty spaces at the end.
I don't think they need more frames.
No?
There is at least four empty frames in there.
Do you want to do it just...
I put two in there, but I don't think they need more than that.
Okay, so on this one, should we put the top cover, the inner cover, where it's supposed to be?
Why?
What is our purpose in keeping it in the middle?
We're keeping the inner cover between the first and the second box just so they can more easily control the amount of space in the first box that they have.
Now we're in hive number two, which is a similar situation as hive number three, where there's the deep and the medium with the inner cover between the two. The frames on top, again, only had honey, so it was just for food.
It'd be cool if you could freeze brood. Look at that, you can see them running in a crowd.
Brood in the top.
Yeah.
So is the queen in the top?
It's possible.
I think in this case we should probably go back to the normal position of the inner cover. The pattern in which they're running, it's interesting. It seems like maybe they're confused. They don't know where to go.
There's no brood on this one.
So there's only a few spots of brood on that one frame in the top. So I think we need to put this one back in the proper order. Hold on. Don't put that down. Way too many bees on the bottom.
Is there a lot of bees on the bottom?
Yes. So, we need to get that top box. Moved over. And then the inner cover on top of that.
That is right there. They're all coming towards the back. Okay, there are a lot of bees on this.
Our goal here is to get those bees to drive them down into the hive so that we're not transferring them over. Again, this one has 9 frames.
A lot of bees.
Not much built on that outside frame.
Nothing built.
I'll feel pretty good if we see the queen in this one, because with the number of bees that we displaced, we just dropped a whole bunch on the ground. Don't see a queen. We displaced a lot of bees in that top box, and since there was a brood, there's the possibility that there was a queen up there, so that makes me nervous. That's a good pattern of brood in the middle. Looks like.
I would say it's not bad. No queen. Thank you.
It's a very active hive, but they're not coming at me.
That's
like
good brood.
Like they used to. Is a good pattern on that one?
It's solid. Still don't see a queen. Probably just blind and missed her. I think that medium frame is coming up next. Solid brood again. No queen. Not the medium frame.
There are a lot of bees in that one. Now they're starting to get a little bit excited about my camera.
I don't see a lot of drones, so I don't think they're splitting. This next one is a medium frame.
Right, when we installed this one, the beekeeper that put this newt together used one medium frame in the deep box. So they actually built some comb on the bottom of the frame to extend it.
It's the shape of a deep frame now.
Yep. You can see on the bottom of this one, below the wooden frame is extra comb where they had extended it down.
Kind of have to treat it like a top bar now, because if I tilt it sideways, it could break.
Yep.
Still don't see the queen. But there's definitely good brood. I never see many queen cups, so.
I suspect this hive has a queen, but the way that we dropped some bees and kind of jostled it a little bit, those are the times that I get a little bit nervous that maybe by our mishandling we're losing queens, which we don't know, but I just get nervous about those things. There's a lot of bees hanging on the outside of that.
Oh my gosh, you can see them move with gravity.
It's pretty crazy. Alright, I think we should probably just wrap this one up. Mm-hmm. We'll bring a couple of deep frames next time we come out to put them in the bottom boxes that didn't have.
I'm gonna go ahead and get them more frames.
Yeah, you might want to smoke before you do that.
Now I understand why there's so many bees in the top box.
Because the bottom was full?
Thank you.
one for the day, which is hive one. The last inspection showed that even though we thought this was a very strong hive, potentially it was weakening.
I don't know why, it's just smoke though.
And there's not as much activity coming in and out of this one, so I'm a little concerned for what we might see in this one.
It's still alive, thankfully. Foundation wants a drone. It's all drone form. No brood, there's some watery looking liquid, so it's probably honey. There's a queen cup.
This is the one hive that survived from last year.
Foundationless brood. More brood.
You're dripping honey.
Sorry guys, didn't say queen.
So there still is brood, I can see it from here.
Still a good queen. I think she just needs more bees. Because, I mean, look, this is all... this is all solid comb, but there's no brood in it, so I think she just needs more bees. There's four frames of bees.
Four frames of bees in the top box. Comb drawn out on the others.
Last time there's a queen cup. Last time they weren't even in the bottom box.
So it's interesting, in this hive, it appears that all the activity of the bees in the first and second box is on one side. Most of the frames on one side of the hive are empty. There's no bees, there's no activity.
Nothing. Nothing.
No brood?
Pollen. This is the food stores. More food stores.
So,
even though there's not a lot of brood and not a lot of bees, I'm gonna say they're still not doing bad, because look how much comb is in here and they're still keeping the whole hive under control.
Right. Okay, so hive one, in my opinion, it's slightly concerning.
It's a weak hive.
It's a weaker hive. We didn't see too much brood. There was some.
Surprised it didn't find the queen.
Most of the brood was in the top box. We didn't see a queen. All right. Well, that is the activity for the day. That's the inspection. Overall, I think we're doing pretty well.
Too bad.
We have one more hive that's supposed to be coming soon to put on the other end of that one. That will be hive number six. But right now, we just have five, and four out of the five look really good. One is a little bit concerning, at least to me.
Thank you for watching this episode, Golden Sun Beekeeper. I hope to see you next time.